everybody. Welcome back to this week's episode of Refined TV. This week, we're going to talk about really the truth behind good carbs and bad carbs. I think it's really important for you to understand there are different types of carbohydrates out there. We do need them in our diet. In a different episode, we're going to talk about the negatives associated with low-carb diets. But today we're going to kind of differentiate between what most people would agree are good carbs and bad carbs. And we're keeping in mind that, you know, everything that philosophically that I believe in and that I promote is really about, just doing the right things the majority of the time, right? We can splurge once in a while, have fun once in a while, but if you're taking care of yourself the majority of the time by exercising, doing the right things, and eating right the majority of the time, it gives you that flexibility to, you know, have some fun, splurge, and eat stuff that, you know, really isn't good for you, but sometimes it just tastes damn good, okay? So, kind of the truth behind good carbs and bad carbs. What we mean by good carbs, in general, are things like veggies, things that are higher in fiber. Anytime you can find carbohydrates that have a decent protein source, that's really important as well. Those are really what we mean by good carbs. We really want, by bad carbs, there's the obvious ones that everyone knows. Candy, chips, things with just empty calories in them, really without any what we call nutrient density. So there's minimal vitamins, minerals, there's no fiber in them. Everybody knows you need to stay away from those things. And for the record, a lot of those types of foods, let's talk about things like those 100 calorie snacks that are promoted as weight loss products, they're garbage. There's really no good in those products where just because there's 100 calories, you're getting 100 calories of absolutely nothing in them. And you're going to be hungrier a lot quicker. I'd much rather you eat something that had some real nutrients in it and, again, some real fiber in them. Okay, so most people agree that those are the bad carbs. You want to minimize those and stay away from them, although I will recognize that some people don't always understand the food industry and how it's to their benefit to try and make you believe that certain foods are good for you and to make them diet. So they will promote the fact that they are enriched with certain vitamins and minerals. That does not make something healthy. Just because it says organic, naturally grown, does not make it healthy. Okay? So other things that sometimes there's a misconception about when we talk about carbohydrates are really the grains. And for the most part in our North American diet, those are the types of things that people really overeat. And for the most part, those are the types of things that people really need to minimize in their diet. Unless you're an endurance athlete exercising at a high intensity level, five or more days per week, most people really need to cut back on their grains. And by cut back, I mean for most people, 2 to 4 servings per day is the maximum they should have of most grains. And by grains, we're talking about rice, cereal, pasta, bread, those types of things. And of those 2 to 4 servings per day, and just for the record, one serving of bread is one slice of bread. It's normally about 3/4 of a cup of rice, about a cup of pasta. It's really not that much. That's one serving. And cereal is one that easily, most people in the morning, if you're not measuring things, you could be getting 3 to 4 servings of. So people really overeat those. So we do want to cut them down to 2 to 4. And even the 2 to 4 servings that you're choosing, we want to try and make sure they're from whole grain sources. When you're looking on the food labels of something that's advertised as whole grain, you want to make sure that 100% whole wheat is listed first on that list, because food manufacturers know that people are looking for whole grain products, and just by putting whole wheat or whole grain on something makes people automatically think they're making a better choice, when in fact, all they had to do is put a tablespoon of whole wheat in that whole product, and that basically means it's minimal in terms of the impact it's having on our health, okay? When 100% whole wheat is listed first on the list, that means that product, that's where the majority of the flour is coming from in that particular product, okay? So when we talk about the bad carbs, the obvious ones are the candies and the things like that, and those, again, those crappy snacks, those 100 calorie snack items. But the other thing that we consider to be the bad carbs really are the grains. And by bad, we mean we just want to minimize them. I'm not saying don't eat them at all, okay? But we do want to minimize them. The majority of our carbohydrates should come from things like vegetables and fruits. That's really where we want to focus on, okay? So try and cut those grains back. There's other things that need to happen in your diet overall to make that work. I mean, the right amount of protein, the right amount of fiber, eating regularly throughout the day is going to make it easier for you to cut back on those grains. So just keep that in mind as you're doing this. But for most of our clients who want to be healthy, lose weight, be fit, feel great, have more energy, we need to cut back on their grains. Okay? So thanks for checking in. Mike Bates from Refined TV.